But let's take out the good old ancient aliens picture. This one's fun because it, I mean, people have so much freaking mind control on this. When this stuff is like, it's all the same. I mean, just because you've been programmed with this one thing, all of a sudden you can't understand anything. How about this symbol right here? You know, maybe I'll find something and I'll blow that up bigger for you so you can see the symbol. I mean, tell you what it is if you actually knew that it's the cube. That's a pretty good spot for it, right where it should be, huh? Telling you what it is, but no. No! That's aliens flying around in spacecraft.
And so against all odds, Judah the Maccabee won the right for his people to live and learn in the way of their forefathers.
God.
But after the war, the people of Israel had a difficult task.
Let's play with some symbols. Got the old Paramount logo, the road into the sun, riding off into the sunset, and everything that goes along with it. Now let's look at another way to symbolize that.
Though Antiochus had been driven from the land, he had left their cities and their holy temple in a terrible mess.
And how about an old classic? Asking questions like, what is the dance floor?
Wow, this is worse than our room, Lillian.
I don't know, Philip. I can still see the floor.
Mom, when you drop something, put it back up.
Top of your TV.
I know you didn't touch it. Get over here.
Don't touch it, cop.
Oh, Mike, hold this. Why me, Mike? Mike, thank you, take this up, but there's a real big ball.
The ball being in the sky that projects 3D is the old information and what that stuff is about. Talking about it is almost impossible, because we all think we're so smart. Oh, they were so stupid, then the earth was flat and all that. Keeps you, that kind of thinking, that programmed thinking, is what keeps you from understanding what the dance floor is, what we all live on. So here's another representation of it.
Yep, but it's all broke up.
I didn't do it.
You know, and it's got this big thing.
And their beautiful menorah, which was supposed to burn forever, was broken.
the windows. Windows to the soul. This is all fractal teachings. Same thing to symbolize many, many things. And here we get subtle with it. And of course, the old classic. The old classic, the Statue of Liberty pose, holding the cup up, the broken pillar waving by.
And its flame put out.
Shlom, they don't know for menorahs.
A menorah is like the nightlight of our people.
What are you doing?
Hey, Mike found a map.
Yeah.
Hey, look, look, look. That says 1632. Is that a year or something?
There's the house. The house we're in. Mom's house. The haunted house. The house you dared to stay in overnight. And of course, we're looking at the same stuff. But you should be asking questions about what these things actually are. Not pointing fingers. Not so much worrying about who this came from or, you know, this is Masons or what's going on. Rather, why is it everywhere?
Of darkness it shines in the whole world, reminding us not to be afraid to be different, but to be proud who we are.
Hey, that's not bad, Cookie. You just make that up.
I'm winging it here. Give me a break. Give me a break. Give me a break.
Your Uncle Shlomo is right. It's like the nightlight of our people. And it was filled with oil.
That makes it burn. Some people use candles.
But you can't understand. You're looking at exactly the same thing right here.
So, the people repaired their temple, but the Greeks had left only enough oil to burn in the menorah for one.
But they lit the menorah anyway.
What are we gonna do? It'll take 8 days to make more oil.
What they needed was a miracle.
Yeah, a miracle. Bubble, whatever that is.
That's when something good happens that you thought could never happen.
Well, that'll never happen.
But one day went by. And then another, and another, until finally, the 8 days had passed, and the flame was still burning. And to this day, we light the menorah every year to remember the miracle of Hanukkah.
No, it's your top scoring pole position.
Yes, it's a year, Chuck.
Look,
great.
It's a map of our coastline. What's all that Spanish junk right there?
Who knows, Mouth? Mouth, you said you could translate. Translate, right here.
Yeah, translate.
Ye intruders beware. Crushing death and grief, soaked with blood of the trespassing thief.
Guys, this map is old news. Everybody and their grandfather went looking for that when our parents were our age. I mean, haven't you ever heard of that guy? What's his name? The pirate guy. One-Eyed Willie.
One-Eyed Willie. Yeah, he was the most famous pirate in his time. My dad told me all about him once.
Dad'll do anything to get you to go to sleep.
No. One-Eyed Willie stole treasure once. It was full of rubies and emeralds and diamonds. Diamonds. And then he loaded it all up onto a ship and they sailed away into the sunset.